I love to fill my house with friends and family at Christmas time. To me, that's what the holidays are all about, as well as the birth of Christ. I love to throw one big party every Christmas season where I invite people who are very, very close to me. We all get together and we laugh and we exchange gifts, we sing and we celebrate, and it fills my house with love. Another thing I really love about the holidays is that you take the time to get in touch with old friends. I have been very fortunate over the years to have made some really close friends. My cousin Brenda, my sister Irma, and my sister-in-law, Miss Earlene. Merry Christmas. The dapper young gentlemen that you see on the wall in the black tuxedos are my sons, Clarence, Teddy, Eddie, and Kelf. One of the other reasons, in addition to that, that I like the holidays is it's a time of a lot of cooking for me, and I cook from Aretha's cookbook. Well, I fancy myself a cook. And the lady who helps me, and she cooks for me, Catherine, and I were in the kitchen, and we were baking hams, and so I asked her to assist me that day. She said, okay, fine. Catherine was saying, oh, we're having such a good time. Cooking with the queen. Cooking with the queen. And she was just screaming, I'm cooking with the queen today. And I was just basting the ham and putting a little over here, a little over there. And I kind of pulled the rack out a little too far, and the ham came tumbling out of the oven, and it was rolling across the kitchen. Cooking with the queen. So I said, well, baby, I am literally throwing down today. The Christmas that I liked the best, though, that I most remember, one of them anyway, was I guess I had gone downstairs at least 100 times to see if there was anything there. Finally, I went back downstairs, and everything was there, and I just screamed because everything was under the tree, and there were dolls and tricycles and nurses' kits. I love the nurses' and doctors' kits. One of my friends calls me Florence Nightingale. But it used to have the little stethoscope in it, and I would examine everyone and check everybody out. And it had the little candy pills. That was what I really liked most about it, the little candy pills. So I would buy like 4 or 5 doctor sets just to get the candy. I absolutely treasured the gift that my dad gave me, which was the gift, one of the gifts, of song. And he gave me a sense of timing and certain other things that I call trade secrets, and I just keep to myself. The most special thing that I could ever give my dad was my love.
freshness. Wonders of love.
Holiday songs from Mary Kate and Ashley Olsen, Carly Simon, Tony Braxton, and Kenny G.
Have you guys made up your Christmas list yet?
Yeah, mine says, "Dear Santa, I would like for Christmas a big, big, big monkey and a monkey family."
How many monkeys are in a family?
I don't know, about 20.
No,
that's 20. What I did on my report.
20 monkeys?
Groups of monkeys.
All right, well, Mary Kate, what would you like for your... What did you do? Did you make a list up?
Yeah, I said, "Dear Santa, can I please have a Walkman CD player and some equipment for horses?"
And that's all you want? How much equipment do you want? I mean,
I don't know, about 10 pieces.
Do you remember what we were doing on some of our other Christmas holidays?
Yeah, our cousins came over.
What else?
And we looked for...
Little footprints all over the house from the elves. Remember how the elves would come and leave all the presents? What's this horse's name, anyways?
Remy?
Oh, he's a beautiful horse, isn't he? He's hungry, too. Watch out you don't lose your fingers. Anyway.
The fact that Mary-Kate and Ashley are happy, normal children is really very important to us because they do so many things that normal kids don't do. We make sure that they still maintain a normal life with plenty of playtime. Mary-Kate has always loved horses, and she's very comfortable around them. When I see Ashley riding, I'm really amazed because while they were filming a movie in Canada this year, her horse bolted and ran for the barn. When we finally caught up with her, she was laughing. So it really makes me very happy that after that incident, she still loves horses.
Together, and it's going to be for the trench coat.
Here we go.
They have to deal with autographs, press conferences, photo sessions, like this one, for their new Detective Home video series.
We're the Trench Coat Twins. We'll solve any crime by dinner time.
Because we're on vacation for the holidays, Mary-Kate and Ashley were afraid that Santa wouldn't find them this year. But they learned a song that's made everything okay.
If you go away for the holiday, Santa can track you down. If you're visiting Grandma in Alabama, he'll know you're out of town. In a far-off place, he'll be on your case with a dog or toy guitar. 'Cause the guy in red with the giant sled always knows where you are. What if you're in the hospital? Would he find you there? You bet! What if you moved on Christmas Eve? Change of address, no sweat. On a desert isle or lost in space, but somewhere that has no fireplace. Relax, no problem. Hey, that's Santa's job. He's got a reindeer team on a radar beam that's flocking on your address, delivering toys to the girls and boys. 100% success. If you're on a ship or a camping trip or a speeding railroad car, the guy in red with the giant sled always knows where you are. The guy in red with the giant sled always knows where you are. Santa knows where you are.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Christmas is a time of miracles and celebration. I'd like to celebrate a miracle that occurred today, named Ryan. He was flown here to New York City to be with us this evening by the Make-A-Wish Foundation. Ryan's wish was to come watch us film this segment tonight. We never planned to use him as a part of the show, but what happened was so special that it captured all of our hearts.
Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Ho, oh, jingle, 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 jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Yeah. He asked him to be assistant director, and he came through with flying colors.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
Get it comfortable.
Tommy, sit in your seat.
Okay, sorry. sorry, right?
TC, you gotta come in closer to us. Camera three, can I see a shot of Carly?
Isn't this nice?
Carly, you look beautiful. Okay.
What do you want to do now?
Control room.
Okay.
He's great.
What touched me most of all is that he knows all the words to all of my songs, even those I have long forgotten. He even knows the year I forgot them in.
I had some dreams, they were clouds in my coffee, clouds in my coffee, and you're so vain.
That's it.
You probably think this song is about you. You're so vain. I bet you think this song is about you. Don't you? Don't you?
He sang for us just a moment ago the song that I'm about to sing. It's called Like a River. I wrote it not too long ago about my mother. She was a woman who made sure she found a miracle in each new day. I'm sure she's checking this one out right now. So this is for you, Mom.
Dear Mother, the struggle is over now, and your house is up for sale. We divided your railroad watches among the four of us. I fought over the purse with the other girls, but it was all a metaphor for what is wrong with us. As the room is emptying out, your face so young comes into view, and on the back porch is a well-worn step and a pool of light that you can walk into. Together is over, but I will wait for you forever, like a river. Can you clear up the mystery of the Sphinx? Do you know any more? is over. But I will wait for you forever, like a river. It nice for when I come, like the way I find my bed turned down, coming in from a late night out. Please keep reminding me of what in my soul I know is true. Come in my boat, there is a seat beside me and two or three stars that we can gaze in. I'll wait no more for you, like a daughter, that part of our life together is over.
Christmas.
Still to come, Christmas music from the living room of Kenny G and a song from Tony Braxton.
You know, when you're a saxophone player, you concentrate on the melodies of songs, not the words. And although Hanukkah was my holiday, I've always loved the sounds and the melodies of the Christmas song. And now every time I play these songs, I get this feeling of warmth and of family and of home. And these feelings transcend any specific religion. Well, this holiday is especially special to us because we have Max. I mean, well, actually, he was here last year during the holidays, but he was such
sleeping.
An infant. Yeah, he slept through the holidays last year. Actually, I remember the first time I played my saxophone for him. It was just it was so wonderful because I'd played to him in her stomach for 9 months. And then he comes out, and the first time I played my saxophone for him, I was really nervous about the reaction because I wanted him to really love it. And he just was mellow, and he had a big smile on his face, and he gave me a really nice feeling back that he knew this sound and he had heard it before, and so it made me feel fantastic. This is a starter saxophone.
A starter set.
Here, Max, show him your chops. Max is good with it.
Yay! He needs applause.
Show him your stuff, Max. I remember the first Christmas present I gave you. Do you remember?
Yes.
We didn't have a lot of money in those days. I mean, I know I didn't. You probably, actually, I think you had more money than me.
I think we're even.
But instead of getting you some generic present, I decided that I would give you something from inside of me. And I sat down and I wrote this beautiful song called Songbird. And I was very nervous about sending it to you, by the way. I mean, I did this whole thing at home and I sent you a cassette of the song that was just a little instrumental.
I remember.
And I sent it to you and I said, this is the way I feel about you, and for this holiday season, I think the best thing I can give you is just my heart, or something like that. And I gave you the song Songbird.
I couldn't believe the song, first of all, but to give a gift like that to somebody, an expression like that of how you feel and of the times or whatever you're feeling, it's just, it's so it's just so overwhelming to receive a present like that. I thought, great, what am I going to give you now? So,
so you
gave
came
me a
up
blue
with,
scarf.
With a blue scarf, yeah.
But
I see how you got from one to the other. I understand. The song I want to play for my son Max for his first Christmas is a song written by Irving Berlin, who was also Jewish. It's called White Christmas, and I think it's a gorgeous song that says everything there is to say about the holiday season. Walter? For Max's cue. That's it. Max, your turn. Merry Christmas, everyone, and Happy Hanukkah, and may your holiday season be filled with love and joy. Thanks.
Coming up, Barry Manilow, Amy Grant, Vince Gill, and Tony Braxton bring some holiday cheer to some very special kids. Christmas at Home with the Stars will continue in a moment here on ABC.
In cities like this across the country, people are gathering to spend the holidays at home. But as we know, not every American has a home to go to. That's why we've come here, to the Los Angeles Mission, to share some Christmas spirit with children who are homeless at this holiday time. When I was a little girl, my family and I were entertained at shelters and community centers every Christmas. My parents passed down to my sisters and me a concern for less fortunate people. And even when we asked Santa for our own gifts, we were taught to think about those who might be getting no presents at all. Your heart can't help but go out to these beautiful children, but you have to put on your best face, because what they really need is love and laughter in their lives.
What's your name?
John Dende.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
I'll be a Santa like you.
Oh! Thank you, thank you, thank you. you.
These children have a special relationship with the Los Angeles Mission. They are among hundreds who come here weekly for food, clothing, and special activities. Many of them live with their families in overcrowded hotel rooms in the downtown Los Angeles area. And although they presently lack homes, they certainly don't lack spirit.
What's your name?
Hashim.
Hashim? How old are you? You're four? You're five? What do you want to be when you grow up?
A doctor.
A doctor? What kind of doctor?
An eye doctor.
An eye doctor, really? Well, that's great. What's your name?
Joanna.
Hi, Joanna. Well, can I get a hug from you?
Thank you so much.
Tell me, what would you do if you were president? What would you do?
If I was president, I'd like to get more policemen out on the street to stop the gangs and the violence.
Very good answer. Can I have a hug from you too?
Although we've brought Thank gifts you. To the mission, the best gift I can give anyone is a song.
Do 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 do. On an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe helps to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow with light are just leaves. Tonight, they know that Santa's on his way, and he's got lots of toys and many goodies on sleigh, and every mother's child is gonna smile to see a reindeer. Really know how to fly, and to a wine offering this simple phrase, kids from 1 to 92, yeah, though it's been said many times, many ways. Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to you.
Christmas kids, I know next year is going to be a whole lot better.
When we return, we'll spend Christmas in the country with Vince Gill and Amy Grant.
Our Christmas celebration always starts the day after Thanksgiving. We load up as a family in a truck and go to this same tree lot we've gone to every year for the last 12 years, and we buy a Christmas tree. And it's not because we did anything fancy or special, it was just because we were together as a family.
Can't you hear the prayers of every childlike heart tonight? Rockies are calling, Denver's snow falling. Somebody said it's 4 feet deep, but it doesn't matter. Give me the laughter. I'm gonna choose to keep.
You wanna count?
Another tender Tennessee Christmas, the only Christmas for me, where the love circles around us like the gifts around our tree. Well, I know there's more snow up in Colorado than my roof will ever see. Tender Tennessee Christmas is the only Christmas for me.
Can I see this?
Yes, you can. It's a tree. You want to go look at it? Okay.
That was tender.
Go look at it.
That was Tennessee.
One tradition that we have around our house at Christmas is that the day after Thanksgiving, we go and buy our Christmas tree. And by the time Thanksgiving weekend is up, the whole house is decorated and Nat King Cole's playing on the stereo. And we enjoy the decorations and the tree all the way through Christmas until the big event, New Year's Eve. That's the day we take all the ornaments off the tree and we drag the tree out into the front pasture and we lace it with fireworks. I say we. Actually, Gary does the whole thing. He laces the tree with fireworks, and then when all of our friends are here celebrating New Year's Eve, we bring in the New Year's with kisses and cheers, and then we all go out in front of the house and set the tree on fire, and that thing explodes way up into the sky.
It is the world's shortest yet most amazing fireworks display.
That's right.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow, Teddy, we're in trouble.
We have an army of guys with fire extinguishers in the Williamson County Sheriff's Department to make sure we don't all kill ourselves, but it is pretty incredible.
Yeah.
It's a great way to start a year.
Christmas with children is unbelievable. It's so special. I think my favorite memory with our children happened 2 years ago. It's so hard to repaint the picture exactly the way it happened, but we heard a commotion upstairs, and Matt and Millie were convinced that they had seen Santa out their window. And Gary and I walked upstairs, and we're looking out the window with them, and sure enough, a guy in a red suit walked across the front yard. Well, of course, we had to tell the kids, get in bed, he's not going to come unless you're asleep. And we left their room, and Santa actually made his way up the front stairs and came into their bedroom. And we know this happened because my brother-in-law, Jerry, had been outside and had seen a guy in a red suit, so he verified the story on their behalf. Mm-hmm. The funny thing was, the next morning, they walked in our bedroom, and Gary and I, of course, are asleep, begging for mercy, let us have a little more time. And Matt had gotten a sword under that tree, and Millie had gotten a Polly Pocket, right?
Right.
They played and played and played on our floor for like 45 minutes. We're thinking, oh my gosh, this is too good to be true. It's Christmas morning, and they're playing with a sword and a Polly Pocket. So finally, we sort of wake up and say, well, okay, kids, come on, let's go downstairs and see what Santa left. And they went, Mom, this is what Santa left.
This is it. That's the stuff you got us. This is what Santa
left. We looked at ourselves and thought, we got 3 months of credit cards to pay off. We could have gotten by with a sword and a Polly Pocket. Oh, well, live and learn.
You know, the great thing about living on a farm is that there's room to really stretch out and enjoy your hobbies. So we took one of the old barns and turned it into a recording studio.
And we sing with friends and neighbors in the music business, Vince Gill and Michael W. Smith. In fact, this year I got a chance to sing a duet with Vince, and we're having a party down at the barn, and I think he's waiting. If I had my Christmas wish, it would be that for years and years and years, people would ask us to sing this song.
Coming back to
no doubt about it. Sometimes life is funny. You think you're in your darkest hour when the lights are coming on in the house of love. Ooh, house of love. Oh, you've been up all night thinking it was over. He's been out of sight, at least for the moment. But when something this strong, ooh, gets a hold on you, the odds are 99 to 1. It's got a hold on him too. Well, I bet you any amount of money he'll be coming back to you. Ooh, I know there ain't no doubt about it. Life is funny. You think you're in your darkest hour when the lights are going on in the house of love. When the lights are coming on in the house of love. And now when the house is gone and you're alone inside, you gotta listen to your heart and put away your foolish pride. Though the storm is breaking and thunder shakes the walls, love with a firm foundation ain't never, never, never gonna fall. Well, I bet you any amount of money is funny. You think you're in your darkest hour when the lights are coming, lights are coming on.
A Christmas wish comes true for Barry Manilow.
It's kind of bizarre spending Christmas out here in California. People walking around in shorts and getting suntans on the beach and all. I come from Brooklyn, New York. I come from the East Coast where Christmas is Christmas. It snows, it's slush, you know. But they do their best here. It's awfully pretty and the people are great. It sure is beautiful, though. They try to make it look wintry. When I was growing up, we didn't celebrate Christmas. You know, I come from a Jewish neighborhood, and we didn't celebrate Christmas where I came from. I was jealous about it, though, because I loved it. I've always loved Christmas, you know. They had these beautiful Christmas carols, you know, Silent Night, and Hark the Herald Angels Sing. What did we have? I had a little dreidel. We made it out of clay. The worst written song in the world. I was going shopping in Beverly Hills, and there were Santa Clauses out there, and there were Santa Clauses flying over Rodeo Drive, and there are all sorts of Christmas decorations, but it's kind of strange because everybody's walking around without their coats on and in their shorts. You know, I've spent so much time on the road singing and making music on the road that whenever I get a chance to come home, it's always such a treat. And whenever I get a chance to come home during the holidays, it's like a big Christmas present for me. So this song is especially appropriate. Whoever wrote this must have been away a lot. Oh, there's no place like home for the holidays. For no matter how far away you roam, when you pine for the sunshine of a friendly gaze, for the holidays, you can't beat home, sweet home. Ain't that the truth? I grew up in the slums of Brooklyn, New York, a neighborhood called Williamsburg, Brooklyn, New York. It was a pretty rough neighborhood, but there was a lot of love. My parents were very hip. They were always mad about the big band music that came out of the 40s, came out of their youth. I always knew that I was going to be a successful musician. I never doubted it. I never thought that I would ever be a successful entertainer, singer. That was a big surprise, a wonderful surprise, a wonderful gift. I was born too late. That's what I've always figured. You know, when I got into the pop music business, I had to learn how to do that. But the easiest kind of music for me to sing are these old, fantastic standards. Christmas is a time for wishes. And so when the producers of the show asked me what I wished for Christmas, so I said, that's what I want to do. I want to sing a great song that came out of the big band era with a big band. And then they said, so well, how are we going to get a big band in your house here? So I said, we can't do that, I guess. But if you really, really wanted to give me my Christmas wish, you'd find me a big band, I'd go to a studio, and I'd sing some famous song that came out of the big band era. So they did.
I stand at your gate, and the song that I sing is of moonlight. I stand and I wait for the touch of your hand in the June light. Sets me dreaming, my love. Do you know that your eyes are like stars brightly beaming? I bring you and sing you a moonlight sail.
As you can see, I got my Christmas wish, and I hope you get yours. Hope you get millions of them. Happy holidays, everyone, and Happy New Year. It's just another New Year's Eve, another night like all the rest. It's just another New Year's Eve. Let's make it the best. It's just another New Year's Eve. It's just another old lang syne, but when we're through, this new year you'll see will be just fine. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year.
Travel provided by Continental, whose over 40,000 employees join in wishing you and your family the happiest of holidays. Continental, it's more airline for your money.